My name is Brett Lyther. I'm an R&D engineer here at ACT, and today we're going to talk about pulsating heat pipes and their applications. So right here I have a small sketch of a pulsating heat pipe. So these black squiggly lines here are the channels inside of the PHP, and on the other side you have a condenser and an evaporator. So on the evaporator side, we have the working fluid that is getting evaporated and turning into a vapor. So as that fluid turns into a vapor, the volume expands here. And then on the condenser side, where we're applying cooling, we have the fluid, which is in a vapor form, then condensing into the liquid, so the volume contracts. And so up above here, I've highlighted that with the expansion and contraction of the fluid volume, you get this oscillating motion where it goes back and forth. And you have your liquid slugs and your vapor plug. And what this does is it helps efficiently transport heat from one location to the other. It helps with heat spreading, things like that. So you have a heater location and then typically a cold end or an end user. Now, here I have a couple samples with us. One of the ways that we're working on developing PHPs is through additive manufacturing. So this plate here was 3D printed using an aluminum compound, and we have the fill tubes along the outer edges to charge the plate with working fluid, which charges the channels, and then it goes through this process that I described before. And then we have a second way that we can manufacture these, which is through vacuum brazing. So with this one, we just have a single fill tube on the side here where nothing is welded yet, but this is a second type of manufacture that we can do for developing PHPs. So if you have any further questions on the applications of PHPs or how they work, feel free to contact ACT using our website.